man tattooed long, 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 long. Bia, bia, baby, bia. Amarajuku, baby, bia.
What's good, everyone? It's your girl, Amarachi. Yes, and I'm here with another video. This is another episode of my purity series. This video is honestly going to be short, sweet, and straight to the point. Why are you waiting to get yourself together before you come to Christ? A lot of us like to say, oh, I need to party all the party. I need to party. I need to go smoke. I need to drink. I need to do everything I need to do so that I can fully focus on God. And that is probably the stupidest decision you could ever, ever try and make, because you are simply just trying to use your own efforts to get right with God. What you don't understand is your salvation is a gift. It's not something that you need to earn. We sit around and we keep saying, I'm gonna get myself together. Oh, I need to do this before I get to Christ, before I can fully focus on God. Do that, we forget how God wants us at our imperfect stage. God died for us because he knows that we're imperfect. He knows that we fall short. He knows that we sin. He knows that we fall short. The Bible says that we fall short of God's glory every single day. There's never a day that you're not gonna fall short. So why do you wanna continue to wait before you can fully give your life to him? The Bible says that in our weakness that he is made strong. So that means that God wants you at your weak point. He wants you when you really can't do nothing. He wants you even though you might have had sex with 10 people. He wants you, like, you know, he wants you even though you're trying to get over this addiction to weed or pornography. He wants you even though you had sex last night. He still wants you. And it doesn't mean that you need to go on some streak and you can't approach God, because that's the devil. That's a lie from the enemy trying to take you away from God. Because who are you to say, I'm gonna wait till I'm ready? The Bible says that nobody knows the hour nor the time that he will come. And y'all, I'm telling you, and I'm not even saying it because I'm trying to preach, I'm saying it for myself too, that God is coming sooner than we know it. It may not even be this year. It may not be next year. It may not be 10 years from now, but he's coming. And we don't know when he's coming. The book of Matthew 25, it talks about the bridesmaids and the groomsmen and how he delayed. And only five of the wise bridesmaids, they had extra oil for their lanterns, while the other foolish ones didn't. And when the time came, the five that were wise were able to just go straight to the groomsmen when he came. And the other five had to go buy more oil. Once they got to the door, it was too late. The Bible says the door was locked, and the groomsmen told him that he did not know who they were. And we don't want God to tell, we don't want to get to the heaven gates and God is telling us that he does not know us. We don't want that, y'all. And I really, really want us to not wait till the last minute when it's too late to try and get your life together. It's you don't have time to go buy that oil. Like, you don't have time to get it together. You don't have time to, oh, let me get my life together. No. The only way you're getting your life together is by getting it together to Christ. Crawling to his feet, because in our weakness, he is made strong. I'm telling you now. And I'm not saying it because the Christian walk is easy and it's easy to just switch up your life overnight. No, of course not. But let's be wise and let's stop fooling ourselves. Let's stop telling ourselves that things are okay when we know deep down that it's not. It's really sad and it's really scary sometimes too, because you just wonder, like, God, am I gonna make it? Like, am I gonna be able to be raptured? And literally the Bible says that we have to work out our salvation with fear and trembling. So we really need to examine ourselves. If there's anybody that's offended you and that you feel like, you know, you're mad at them, or anybody that you offended to, just tell God, just pray right now and just tell God, you know, God, examine my heart. Please help me to forgive those who have hurt me. Because, and I know how you guys feel. A lot of people, sometimes it's not even that they want to get their life together. It's just simple fact that they've been through so much and they're just like, how can a God that is so great allow me to go through this? But as crazy as it sounds and as weird as it sounds, he's still God. Like, that's just it. And there's really no way, two ways about it. I can't really argue with it, because I'm not gonna sit here and argue with you with things of God, because God is just God. And it's easy, and what will make things easier is if you believe it, because the time will come where there's no time for you to believe it anymore. And it's not even to scare you, but it's genuinely because it's something that's deep in my heart too, and it's been a burden too, because it's like, I'm right, you need to get it together too. Because if you're not careful, you won't make it. And that's just the genuine honesty. So I examine my heart every day when I think of the people who have hurt me. that I even they don't even know that they've hurt me. Even though they know they've hurt me, I still try and I tell God, like, God, I really want to let these people go. I really am. I'm really sorry if I offended anybody else as well too. Like, I had a dream last night and I saw this lady that has really, really offended me in my dream. And it's just like, I think that was the way of God telling me, let it go. Like, you know, you really have to just examine your heart and tell God, you know, God looks in our heart. That's one thing I love about God, is your works are nothing to him. So stop trying to earn your salvation, because your salvation cannot be earned. Let me tell you that now. But what it's about is you genuinely loving God and doing the things of God because you love him. So reading your devotional, not because you want to get to heaven, but because you love God. But praying, not because you want to get to heaven, but because you love God. He examines your heart. He knows your heart. So really talk to God and tell him, like, you know, God, I want to get right with you. And then make efforts towards that. Not because you want to go to heaven, but because of the love he has for you. God is not a human being, y'all. That's one thing about him that's so great. He is not a human being. So really right now, despite whatever you did, you could pray right now. You could tell God that you're sorry and he will forgive you. You don't even have to say anything else. Just know in your heart that you really, really are sorry, and he will forgive you. Do not wait till it's too late. Don't sit and say, oh, okay, I'm gonna drink all I need to drink, and then when I'm done, I'm gonna go to God. It's going to be too late. Do not wait till it's too late, because when it's too late, there's no exceptions. God is a merciful God. That's very true. But he's giving you a time limit to his mercy, because he told you nobody knows the hour nor the day that he's coming. So you need to be ready. He comes like a thief in the night. Do you know when a thief comes? If you knew when a thief was coming, you prepared to that day. But because you don't know when he's coming, you need to be ever ready. Ever ready. I love you guys so much. This video is not only for you once again, but it's for me too, because I mean, I'm young. I'm going through a lot. I'm still learning myself. So this Christian walk isn't easy, y'all. It really isn't. But I'm sure we can do it with each other's help, you know, godly community type thing. I love you guys so much. I will see you guys in my next video. Stay blessed. Stay great. Be ready. God is coming. Love him. Don't be scared, because I know sometimes it can be scary, like, oh, God is coming, I got to do this. Just live your life. Just be happy, though, and be remembered. Keep that in the back of your head. Like, if I was in this place, would God be okay with this? Is this somewhere that I want to be to shine my light? Things like that. And that's just me being honest, because that's things that I'm going to start working on and really try to do, because it's really important. It really is. But anyway, I love you guys so much. I will talk to you guys in my next video. See you later. Make sure you subscribe. Bye.